I'ma crush it. Call me the golden boy.
Welcome to Unsung, the nonprofit news magazine show. I'm your host, Anthony Walker. As you can tell by my hair, it's a pretty windy day as we bring you this episode from Point Park, right across from Heinz Field, where the Steelers have a game tonight. Social media has become a new and important tool for nonprofits to share their stories and reach new people. Engaging individuals and working together is a key to doing big things in our community. In this edition of Unsung, we give you a preview of PodCamp Pittsburgh, a local gathering of social media professionals where you can learn how to harness these tools in a social setting. Before we check in with them, let's take a look at the nonprofit news that is happening in our area. The Pittsburgh Downtown Partnership is seeking proposals from individual artists, collaborative artist teams, commercial retail businesses, arts and culture-related businesses, and other for-profit or nonprofit organizations or entities that will provide the most high-quality and innovative approaches to activating vacant storefronts in downtown with both a daytime and nighttime presence. The most innovative, feasible, and creative proposals will be selected to participate in the program. Activation will range from a short-term minimum of 6 months up to 12 months with the potential for long-term occupancy. Deadline is September 13th and grants will be awarded from $1,500 to $10,000. The Pittsburgh Tote Bag Project, which supplies reusable shopping totes to area food pantries, will hold a tote bag drive at PodCamp Pittsburgh. If you plan to attend the event on September 17th and 18th, please consider bringing a donation. Totes reduce the use of plastic bags, reduce cost to food banks, and make transporting the food easier for clients. CMU International Justice Mission in Zonta Three Rivers, Pittsburgh North announced a free viewing of the human trafficking documentary, Sex and Money, The National Search for Human Worth. The 90-minute screening will take place on Tuesday, September 6th at 7 p.m. in the McConomy Auditorium on CMU's campus. A brief panel discussion comprised of subject matter experts will follow the film. Sex and Money is a documentary about the sex trafficking of minors within the United States and the modern-day abolitionist movement fighting to stop it. Human trafficking is a $9 billion industry worldwide, second only to drug smuggling. According to the film producers, there are an estimated 100,000 to 300,000 American children commercially sexually exploited each year in the United States. PodCamp Pittsburgh is coming up, and it's a personal favorite for us at Unsung. Let's talk to some of the organizers about this year's event.
So PodCamp is a community on conference where basically new media content creators in Pittsburgh get together to produce a conference for other people who are interested in learning about or creating content such as a blog or a podcast or social networking, new media.
Which means that it is about media that helps you interact and share information with other people, very basically, which can be television, could be radio, but as the years go on, we cater more to whatever we're considering to be new media, whether it's issues with dealing with sharing so much information these days. Obviously our media stream these days has become massive.
So we teach people in the community about how to, anything from basics, how to start a blog, how to start a Facebook account, how to start an audio podcast, to more intermediate and more advanced sessions that show how to use it more specifically in different arenas.
The swath of people that come to PodCamp is kind of amazing. We get the people in the 20s who are hip, but we also get suit and tie business individual, we get politicians, we get radio DJs, we get broadcasters, we get middle-aged folks who are trying to get their personal business off the ground. As someone who is a founder of a nonprofit, I absolutely understand the importance and value of selling a message, which is what nonprofits do for the most part. The idea is, you know, take something that you care about, whether it's bettering your community or something like that, and the ability to spread that is your bread and butter. That's the only way that your nonprofit is going to succeed, because it's not about turning a buck. It's about getting that message out there and educating people in whatever you're going to do. So social media has become an incredible tool to help nonprofits evolve, get more support, share their message and in the end succeed in whatever their mission may be.
Because you can come in, not spend any money, have a couple of people learn about ways that they can promote their message, use Facebook to maybe a fuller advantage, or find out about what other tools are out there for communication and how to reach the people that they want to reach and keep their organization, you know, kind of on the forefront of modern web tools.
Among all businesses, there's a good chance that nonprofits can get the most benefit out of PodCamp.
Because I think that the best sessions are the sessions that really where the crowd can get involved. And the session leader isn't the expert. It's where you get on a topic where the crowd can the community can get involved and really participate in a conversation. And that's where you find you learn the most and you have the most ideas kind of come and gel together.
The culinary quarry session from last year's PodCamp. PodCamp Pittsburgh 5. As a foodie, I love to see how other people use social media with regard to food. His blog pretty much entails that. He goes over various things with regard to, you know, recipes that he's trying, to different things that he's doing with food. And I really enjoyed the session for that purpose because it was something that hit home to me as a cooker and a baker and person loving to prepare and do food, that this guy is using social media in a way to promote that. And I just thoroughly enjoyed the session.
And PodCamp, I will absolutely give PodCamp Pittsburgh credit for jumpstarting me into my my career as everything in Pittsburgh.
You can find information at podcamppittsburgh.com. If you're interested in volunteering, we have a volunteer page there. You can just submit your information and can learn more about where else to find PodCamp on Twitter, Facebook, what hashtag we're using. We're using PCPGH6 for this year's event. And you can find out all the information about this year's sessions. We have tons of content from PodCamp Pittsburgh 5, PodCamp Pittsburgh 4, video from every session from those previous two events, which is just fantastic. And plus we have blog posts going up daily. There's a lot of great information there.
In this episode's video spotlight, John Powell takes us for a tour of Sycamore Island. Hey, get out there, have some fun, and send us your videos too. 2011 Walk to End Juvenile Diabetes is September 17th with two locations, Schenley Park and University of Pittsburgh Greensburg campus. Join a team or pledge your support at jdrf.org. Partners for Quality Foundation cordially invite you to attend the 8th annual Pittsburgh Fashion Story, Friday, September 9th, featuring a film-inspired fashion show and cocktail party. Expect to see runway looks from local retailers inspired by locally produced films such as The Dark Knight Rises, Flashdance, Night of the Living Dead, She's Out of My League, and more. This is a sellout event each year, so get your tickets early. You can order them through Black Tie Pittsburgh at blacktie-pittsburgh.com under event registration at the top. A rally for peace for all Northside and surrounding areas will be held on September 17th from 4 to 7 p.m. in West Park on West North Avenue. Thanks for watching this episode of Unsung. Be sure to check out our other videos and our Unsung Uncut series over at pittsburghonvideo.org. Share us with your friends and leave your comments as to what good you do in our community. I've been your host, Anthony Walker, reminding you to keep it awesome, Pittsburgh. We'll see you next time.
Said I'ma crush it. Call me the golden boy, cause it shine whenever I touch it. Don't rush it, the flow comes naturally. Actually, the whole hood after me. Masterpiece, I outran a pace car. And these dudes fucking mad cause they can't even find a day job. I stay hard with or without Viagra. And I said the flow crush like the fourth of Niagara. I'm after a major label budget, but since I'm not